Hey, it's 1 o'clock in the morning, Friday, February 25, 2011. Looking at a drawing. A lot of red lines on that. But the part we're gonna make, or we already made it. A little shadowing here. Anyway, it's part number 19 for a Ford. It consists of three parts welded together. And what I'm doing now is the last welding. This green thing is my welding sleeve. Keeps my arms from getting sunburned, and I learned that. Anyway, this is a coupling nut. It's about an inch long. Let me pull one out of the bin. I'm not ready for this yet. Here we go. So if you look at it, you can see it's a little taller than the one that's in the part. And that's because we draw that one in the part through a hole. Draw it all the way down to the other side with a bolt. So it's locked in there, and all I have to do is tack it around its perimeter, and it's in there permanently. Will not bend, won't do anything else. By the way, that's stainless steel. It's the only way to do it. This surface of the part is coated with a wax, so when I weld this, any little spatters are going to hit this wax, and you can see it on my finger there, and it'll burn into the part a little bit, but it won't stay there. I can rub it off, or I can sand it off real easy. That's the way on both of them. The reason this bolt is in the hole here, it's loose, just sitting in there. It's a plug. I can't have spatter coming up out of the weld and going into the threads of the part. That's not good. So you got to put a plug, little bolt in there, you're good to go. Some more details about this part. These are actually reversed. One is on the right side, one is on the left side. But anyway, this is the main part that lifts the rear of the bed of a Ford. And what it is it's a shoe that's 3 inches thick by 3 inches wide. Runs all the way over here to this end. And then it ties into another part. What happens here is there's a gap in it for a cross member on the bed, and there's a gap back here for a cross member on the bed also with a bolt hole that goes through it. And this is the rearmost bolt of a Ford bed. So when you put my kit on the truck, the only thing you're going to see is this nut sticking up, which lines up perfectly with the hole that's already in the bed. So you're going to drop the bed straight down on top of this part. The hole's going to line up, and then you're going to stick a bolt right through the bed, right into this nut, and tighten the bed down onto the truck, onto the kit. And it's a half inch 13, and it's a standard stainless steel bolt that's going to go down to this nut rather than a metric bolt, so it can be replaced at any time. It can be lengthened if you wanted to put a piece of steel or a piece of plywood on the bottom of your bed. All you have to do is match up the holes, stick a little bit longer bolt in there, and you're good to go. Even if it didn't have a bolt in it, the whole thing didn't have a bolt in it, the nut here would allow the bed to go up and down and not move, not jump off of the kit. So the bolt doesn't have to be very tight, just has to be snug, and you're good to go. This part, now that we're welded here, this part gets one hole drilled into it, and the part's finished. This space, like I said, is for another cross member under the bed. There is no bolt in that, so I can't put a nut on that. Over here, the reason that we have another part on top of this is because the way the frame is, there's an obstruction under here on top of the frame. and the obstruction is about a quarter inch tall, so the part is 3/8 of an inch, so you should have 1/16 of an inch clearance when this goes into the other part. The reason there's two slots in this is to allow you to adjust it however you want so it fits the truck. You know, if you've had a crash or whatever, or things just aren't lining up right, there's a slot here that lets you align it. And there's plenty of room in here. You can see how big it is. So the bolt's in there. That's a 1/2 inch bolt also. There's two of them so that when you do adjust it, and the other part that goes on here, there's two holes in it, period. There's no slots in the other part. So that when the bed goes up, it's not going to cock one way or the other because of the holes. The first one I made only had one slot. And I noticed that when you put a load on it, the other part that was riding on the inside here would cock one way or the other, depending on the size of the load. So we just change that. We stick another bolt, stick another slot in there, and it won't cock. Right sides and left sides are the same. They're just reversed. Interesting thing about this shoe that I made, that bolt hole's not in the center of either one of them. And underneath the truck, there's two rivet heads. So if you look at this, those two rivet heads will drop right in top, right in those holes, right there, to line everything up. The rivets are convex, and this is 3/8 of an inch deep, and the rivets are only 1/4 inch, so it won't touch. So this is right in the rear of the bed, rear of the frame. Going to rest right on top of those. Now if they're misaligned a little bit, there's extra clearance around these. The hole is bigger than the rivet. Nothing else on the bottom side. It's just flat, rest right on the frame. We're good to go. So only thing left to do is tack those at low amp, low feed. You need to hold about 1,000 pounds, which is not a big deal, and we're good to go. Nobody's ever seen this. I did weld it without showing all the details. It's not a big deal, except the surface of this part where the bolt goes in is 3/16 inch higher than the edge of this. And then where the other part goes on, it's flush. And that is to prevent interference with the other parts that act upon this. I could make this out of one piece. I'd have to hire somebody to do it. They'd have to plasma cut it and then bend it. And they'd have problems down at this end by the, this is a smaller size. I don't need 3/8 of an inch here on this. So it's only 1/4. I probably don't need 3/8 of an inch on this, but I am Mr. Overkill. So it cost me a little bit of time and effort to make three parts and pop all the holes in it. One of these days, I'll do it right. Meantime, this works. Bye.